exhilarated. It's pretty exciting, and this is the first time I brought my children with me. And I had to explain to my four-year-old son last night a little bit about circumcision. I didn't call it circumcision. I basically told him that I showed him a video. I asked him flat out if it was okay to cut babies. So that's basically our introduction to it. What I'm doing today is for them and for other children, so that's why. I saw circumcision about 20 years ago being performed in a hospital while I was in nursing school, and I didn't do any research after that, but my gut instinct told me after I witnessed that I was not going to do that to a child of my own. So when I was pregnant with him, this would have been 5 years ago, I thought, you know, I'm going to go online just to see why people are doing it. I knew I wasn't going to do it regardless of what I read, but I just wanted to see why people were doing it. And everything I read just convinced me that we shouldn't be doing this, and it just really, that's what made me an activist at that point. And then being asked while I was pregnant with him by the OB if I wanted to have it done, and I adamantly said no, and she wanted to argue with me about it. I thought, why didn't she just take no for an answer? You know, I didn't have the courage at that point to argue with her, but I'm just more and more convinced every day that this shouldn't be happening. And so for people who've never seen it done, because I saw it face to face, I saw it happening to two infants, people have no idea what they're signing up for. So I really feel like it's important to get the word out. We have people thanking us when we're out here. You know that every day when you come out here and you protest, people, you know, you get people that think, why are you out here wasting your time? But then you get people thanking you for being here and speaking out for children. And it's important because they don't have a voice.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.